Hello, my friends, and welcome back to Ace Attorney, Phoenix Wright. Or should I put it in another order? Phoenix Wright, Ace Attorney. Yeah, that sounds more like it. Now, maybe we're finally at the last part of this episode 2 thingy-ding that we were working on. The last thing with the Mia's case. Oh, well, I hope so, at least. I hope this is the last trial, and then we finally put Red White in freaking jail for what that poo-poo scooper has done. Hitting me in the face and, well, us in the face, and also he killed our very, very dear friend, our boss, Mia. And not Mia, my neighbor, but Mia, our buddy, bud, our chief. Okay. I hope it is at least. Oh, let's get into it. Really loud. Oh wow, what voice did we give you? Already forgot! Oopsie! I thought I gave you just a normal voice. Well, I guess this is it.
Yeah. One way or another, this case gets decided today.
I tried to give Phoenix the strange voice, or no, not strange voice, but of other voice than my normal voice, and Maya will have the normal one.
I don't know why I do that, because we're gonna play as Phoenix, so it's gonna be annoying after a while since I have such a bad memory of remembering voices. But we're gonna try. I need to work on this anyway, so yes. Ah! Phoenix, look! Oh no, oh no, 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 no. Oh, okay, it's that person, okay. Well, that's fine. I thought it was gonna be Red White.
Prosecutor Edgeworth. I received a call from the public prosecutor's office yesterday.
Huh?
He told me that whatever Mr. White says today, it will be the absolute truth.
Oh. Your face.
It looks like, yeah, I agree with that, so you're gonna put in jail. This is my game face.
No matter how you try to attack his testimony, if I raise an objection, I have it on good faith that the judge will listen to me.
Look at that smug face.
Blah. What? Does White have the judge in his pocket too?
Of course he does. White has everyone in his pocket.
So, you're saying I'm going to be guilty, end of story?
Sorry, I'm sorry.
I'll do anything to get my verdict, Mr. Wright. Anything. Because I'm a horrible person.
I think that was a reverse. Why? Why? Oh wait, you get the normal voice. Why? Why? How can you torment an innocent person like this?
Because I'm a dish. Innocent. Oh yeah, I like this. Oh yeah, I like to look at down the corners and tell people that they're not innocent. Because I'm an evil person. How can we know that? My eyebrows are stuck like this. The guilty ones lie to avoid being found out. I smell the security guard's farts.
Sorry, I'm so immature. I just don't like short form Red White, so I get very immature because I just am angry at them.
There's no way to tell who's guilty and who's innocent.
But I know you're innocent, so, well, I'm just an Ash. I'm sorry, I shouldn't say that. I'm a purple. Oh yeah, look at my hair, I'm so purple. Sorry, wow, I'm so immature.
All that I can hope to do is to get every defendant declared guilty.
What?
So I make that my policy.
Edgeworth.
Why?
You changed.
From what? From being a poo-poo to a... another poo-poo.
Hmm?
Phoenix! You know him?
No. Don't expect any special treatment of Phoenix Wright. What, so you knew each other? Why? Why do you know each other? That's a poo-poo. That's a poo-poo head. Was that like your nemesis in class? Like, you try to defeat each other, like getting a better grade than another one or what? I bet you just the same as awesome at it, like you were really good. You both were really good at your studies and so on, and then, I don't know, Edgeworth just was on the edge, and it was worth it for Edgeworth. Okay, that was just my humor, so Well, court will be opening. Court will be opening for session soon.
What? But wait! Your defense attorney isn't even here yet. He's not.
I'd be defending myself, thank you.
Badass! What?
Okay, let's do this. Cool gas is
September 9, 10 a.m. District Court, courtroom number 1.
The court is now in session for trial of Mr. Phoenix Wright.
Prosecution is ready, Your Honor. The defense is ready, Your Honor.
Mr. Wright, I assure you, up to doing this.
Yes, Your Honor, I will be defending myself. And cracks in my neck when it went down like that. It was very uncomfortable. I broke my neck, and no doctor wants to help me because right away I was like, no, don't help him, and now I'm in trouble.
Understood. Very well, Mr. Edgeworth. Your opening statement, please.
As the details at the event are already quite clear to the court. Today we'll hear the story of another witness to the defendant's crime.
I see. The prosecution may call this witness.
That went far too smoothly. Why didn't the judge ask Edgeworth why his witness didn't testify before?
It's like he already knows why.
If anyone's going to raise an object about it, I suppose it's me.
Let it go. I mean, it's just the best thing because everything's gonna be against you anyway, but maybe people will be like, oh my gosh, you're so brave trying to stand up against Mr. Robot. Everybody stand up saying hallelujah. Kind of like that.
Yeah, we'll try with the objection, even though I don't feel like it.
Mr. Edgeworth, you owe an explanation to the court.
Why didn't this witness testify in trial against Mrs. Maya Fey?
Mrs. Maya Fey. I'm ever so sorry. Mr. Wine is a busy man, and besides, at the time, I got a lot of money for nothing and buy them, so yeah. I thought that Mrs. Maya's opinion was all that would be needed. Again, my sincerest apologies to the court.
What? What? But you did like a no-no with your head and what? Ugh, Judge, you disappoint me. What do Mr. White have on you? What does that guy got on you? Did he? Is that a fake beard? Is that what it is?
Is this what it's all about? No, who cares? It's not. Of course not. Your beard is real.
I love your beard.
Excellent, Mr. Edgeworth.
I'm so disappointed in you, Judge. I don't like Edgeworth, so I can't say I'm disappointed in you because I never liked you. I'm sorry, everybody. This is one of those people that I just don't like.
Great, it gets a show off and I get nowhere.
That's why I wanted to let it go, but I didn't want to dare because maybe we could some get good points or stuff.
We get a good ending. I don't know if this game is kind of like that, you get different endings.
I would like to call Mr. Redwine to the stand. Oh no, I don't want to see his face. And I don't remember the voice I gave him either.
Hello!
No, that's not the voice.
Please state your full name even though I just said it, Mr. Redwine.
You wish to know the title of my personage? Bling, 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 bling. Oh wow!
Ew, my eyeballs.
Your name.
Yes, that is what I said. Oh dear, do my locution.
What?
Locutions confuse.
Your words confuse me. Wow, you dare to say that even though Mr. Wag got bull on you?
Mm-hmm, okay. Name.
These two are great together.
My name is Red White,
but my friends call me Blanco Nino.
Why?
I am the CEO, or to use a more common term, the president of Blue Corp.
Did you know the victim is Malfoy?
Yes, well, I murdered her, so And that would be a negatory. No, I did not. But I did murder her, so yes.
You were at the Gangwater Hotel the night of the murder?
Correct.
Oh, you agreed to that. And you witnessed the murder from there.
Why tell you what you already know?
Well, because everyone needs to know.
Very well, Mr. White, you may begin your testimony.
If I can't rip this guy's testimony apart, I'm done for.
Well, yeah.
Oh gosh. Why do I always feel like it's the end of the world and I'm the last man standing?
Well, you're not the last man standing. You got all of us on your side. Mr. Mrgreenhp person, that's me, and all our other friends that are watching right now. Including Ray, because Ray's cheering me on, and I was like, talking to Ray just now before I recording this. Like, maybe I'll need your help because I don't like red, white, and I maybe get like all shocked and stuff. So I told Ray, like, I maybe will need some advice, like, I don't know, on anything, maybe I'll need your advice. And Ray was like, okay, so Ray's watching too. So hi, Ray, how you doing? Okay, let's go on with this.
Ray, hello.
Ray, why is flirting with you, Ray? Oh, sorry.
I hope you have made your peace with someone up above, whatever you believe in, Miss Lawyer.
You poop. Let him have it, Phoenix.
Wait, are you a defense attorney? Why are you here?
Okay.
Oh gosh, I don't like your smile was scary.
Let's see, it was about 9, I believe. I was quietly
Oh gosh, these words!
I was quietly perusifying, that's reading to you.
Oh, you poo-poo, stop! It's like you're looking down on me because I can't pronounce words and now you're trying to explain everything. Oh no, stop!
That's reading to you. Some papers by the window.
What papers?
Then I heard a bed.
Then I heard a bedlam coming from outside. What's a bedlam?
I surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way. It was then I saw him. A spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair.
We would never do that.
Needless to say, that man was none other than you, Mr. Lawyer.
Well, Miss Red White called us lawyer and not detective, but I like detectives too, so. Still, the first one to call us a lawyer, not detective.
I called Miss May over at once. She too was flabbergasted, of course. The victim, she ran away, but you gave chase. Then I came and just murdered her because you tried to be like, hey, where do you want to eat dinner for later with Maya? Do you want to go and get tacos? And Mia was like, no, we said we're going to have burgers. And you're like, no, I really want them tacos. Come on, Mia, come on. And then I murdered her. Because I really wanted to eat some tacos too, and I thought that was like the only way to make her understand that tacos is best.
Mia.
Finally, there was a terrible impaction. Then it was all over.
If things occurred as you testified, then I'm afraid the defendant is guilty. Very well, defendant, Mr. Wright. Your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor. Evil stare of doom!
Let's see, it was about 9, I believe.
We gotta look at, okay. It's gonna check everything. At 9. Okay. Well, that's right then. I'm just gonna check if you have anything that we can just throw at them. Okay. Oh wait, we can't use this when I think about it. Alrighty. Okay, I just wanna check everything. Okay, go on.
I was quietly perusifying that reading to you, some papers by the window.
Then I heard a bedlam coming from outside. What's a bedlam? I don't know what a bedlam is. Surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way. It was then I saw him, a spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair. Needless to say, that man was none other than you, Miss Lawyer. I called Miss May over at once. She too was surprised, of course. The victim, she ran away, but you gave chase. Finally, there was a terrible impaction.
Wait, that doesn't make sense, this thing. She ran away, but you gave chase. But she died by the window, so that's really strange. We're gonna press here. Can you be a little more detailed about that? I think it's worth knowing exactly what happened.
Of course, comprende, I understand. The victim was attacked by you and ran to the left. You gave chase and struck her down.
Are you sure?
Bling 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 bling. As you know, I'm always absolutely perfect. No, you're not. Perhaps you could change your testimony to reflect this new detail. The victim ran to the left, and you gave chase.
There was a lamp there, wasn't it?
Finally, there was a terrible impaction that was all over.
But there's no way, because I mean... I don't really dare to throw the picture at him.
Are you sure about that?
How many times must I say it?
Blink, 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 blink.
I am absolutely, possibly perfect. End of story.
How many times must I hear that?
Yeah, right.
Psh, Phoenix. Doesn't something about that strike you as a little odd?
Yes! Okay, we gotta... Maybe we can use the photo. Because... Okay, we gotta look at the floor plans together here. For Red White to be able to see me chasing, or, you know, to see me... I mean, Mia's body was found right beneath the window. So... If the entrance is way over to the right corner, we came in here, and White couldn't possibly be able to see that we came from there, so it's really odd, and the lamp there, it doesn't really make sense, so maybe we should try to present this.
Yeah.
Hope this works.
Your Honor. Oh, maybe this sounds like it's gonna work. Your Honor, the statement contradicts this evidence.
Huh? Oh no, it doesn't- Oh no, dang it! I see it!
Huh, really?
Objection. Dang it! Oh no! My little things!
Whoops, that didn't go so well.
But that doesn't make sense, that thing!
Oh wait, sorry, I should have read that for you. Edgeworth prep Red White for this too? And yeah, it kind of said like that. Sorry, I'm just so focused on trying to solve this. Wow. Anyway, I better find a weakness in there.
Let's see, it was about 9, I believe. I was quietly pursuing that's reading to you some papers by window. Then I heard a bedlam.
What's that? A bedlam? Thank you.
It must have been when you attacked, I assume.
What's a bedlam?
See, continue.
What's a bedlam?
Surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way. It was then I saw a spiky-haired man attacking...
Okay, I'm not gonna do your voice anymore. A spiky-haired man attacking a woman with long hair. Needless to say, that man was none other than you. Should we maybe press here? Because what about Maya? Because, I mean, Maya was there before us. And they shouldn't have... I mean... If both you and Miss May saw me, like Phoenix, like saw him run around trying to kill me and stuff, why weren't we called, you know, before Maya? That doesn't make sense. So maybe we'll try this first, because Maya is weird.
What you just said directly
directly conflicts with Miss May's testimony. Miss May clearly stated that this Sicilian looked like a girl. I've always been proud of my eyesight, Mr. Lawyer. Yes, what is your eyesight? Bull!
Bling, 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 bling.
Well, I kinda lost my eyesight because I always shine those diamonds and gold in my eyes, huh?
Counting both eyes, 40.
Yeah, you have bad eyesight because, I mean, you have two, I mean, what? 40? Oh, I'm sorry for you. Okay,
I'm not sorry at all.
Yeah, badass, I get some glasses.
40? Don't add them together. I think the witness is trying to say his eyesight is good.
Are you really scared? You're really scared of Miss White. Hey, whose side is the judge on anyway?
I don't know. Maybe White's? And
what did you do then?
I called Miss May over at 1, 3 or 2 with surprise, of course.
Impaction. Don't you mean just impact?
Ridiculosity. I think you need to brush up on your language skills.
What? On second thought, perhaps I better leave the whole language thing alone. What? Did Edward prep this guy too, I wonder? Anyway, I better find a weakness in there. What papers?
I don't know. I'm just trying. From it.
By window? You mean the one directly across from the Fane Coal offices?
Correct. That is the only window you see.
And there you were reading papers?
Correct. The Gatewater is a businessman's hotel, and I'm a busy man who had business to do.
Then I heard a bedlam coming from outside. Bedlam? I don't know what a bedlam is.
Surprised, I turned to look at the building across the way.
Okay, we can press here too, I guess. Wait, we did already press here, maybe.
So, you were reading your papers until you heard that sound.
But of course, I am no Snoop.
Of course you are. It's peeping out of windows at night. No Snoop.
Yeah, right.
yeah. Oh yeah, Phoenix, you do not say the same things. You made a career out of snooping.
It was then I saw him, a spiky head man, attacking a woman with long hair.
Did we press here? I think we did. Yeah, we did. Maybe they want us to press here, but that doesn't make sense. Now. We pressed here. Gotta try to press everything, I guess.
What was Miss May doing at the time? She had just finished watching a soap opera on TV and was weeping openly.
But if you think about it, no.
Did you know she had
been taping the Fay office phone?
Why?
Shush.
Irrelevant.
That has nothing to do with the case at hand.
What? Really? Oh yeah, you're forced to be in poo-poo.
I care not. I will answer the lawyer's bold inquiry. Miss May was acting alone when she taped the phone of the Fay woman.
You make a good politician, Mr. White. Because you're fake. Faker.
Ho, after all, I am El Presidente.
Please continue.
We already passed that. We pressed this, I think. Oh gosh, I don't wanna ask Ray for advice, I want to solve this myself. Should we try to press here? We could just try to press everything again. How do you know what time it was?
Because I'm always absolutely perfect, you know?
Oh. Shush, you're so annoying!
No, you're not getting away with that.
Yes, they will. Sadly.
You're so mistrusting, Miss Lawyer. Well, would you trust yourself?
Well, of course, because you're so perfect.
You're like Gaston, but not a good way. Gaston was funny.
Well, maybe not when he was trying to kill Beast and... Oh, spoilers, sorry for spoilers. And, you know, Beauty and Beast, but... Seriously, but still, he was more funny than you. You're just poop.
So what was the proper term for secretary again?
Oh, you're a secretary?
Anyway, Miss May ordered room service for 9. It happened soon after the room service arrived.
That's what Miss May said too. Should we press further? I don't think it's a really good decision. I think it's better to hold back, because that's exactly what Miss May said, and that's exactly what the bellboy says. No, we're gonna hold back. I don't see anything to gain by attacking him on this point any further.
Okay. What were you doing at the time?
I was quietly pursued, but we all are pessimists. Surprised, I turned to look at the building. We did that. We pressed this already, didn't we?
Spiky-haired.
Yeah, you said you were gonna shave your head later after this, but I don't want you to do that, so don't do that. Oh, wow. Okay, really, that was everything we said. I really don't know what to say. Do we have anything? I mean, we had the receipt here where it says Maya. So this doesn't really make sense now when we're apparently the baddie. But I don't know where we can present this really in this talking thing. Finally, there was a terrible impact, and then it was all over. I really don't know. I can try to press everything. I'll be right back. I'm gonna press everything right now. I have been discussing some matters here with Ray. We haven't got anywhere. We just discussed it, like Ray trying to give me some clues or so. But I didn't really understand what we're gonna do. I just... like, Ray said... You try to present something else to the court. Like, that will maybe help more to Mr. White than just pressing him, like we were asked to do in the last case. So, I'm gonna try, instead of the floor plans that we presented, I think it was... Where did we present it? I think we presented it to the left thing. Is that me around to the left? I'm gonna... Because Miss Mays... That was... Wait, what? Right around to the left, yeah. Because Miss Mays testimony... It was just a bunch of lies, right? And then ran to the right, but she was caught and struck. Maybe this was... I don't know. Because this was just a bunch of lies, and I don't... It didn't sound like we could use this in the... Because, I mean, Wright said, yeah, it was just a bunch of lies. We could only save a little of it, but I don't know if we can use it in the case later, further on. So I don't know if this is going to work, but we gotta try everything.
Well, right there. Mr. Y, you have dug your own grave. Oh, whoa, is this? Oh, yeah, oh my gosh, that was just. Oh my gosh, really? This was just. Yes!
I hope this is right. This sounds like it's right. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. Ray, we did it. Oh my gosh, we did it. What is this? I'm perfect.
You said the victim ran to the left. But that directly contradicts Miss May's testimony. Snap doodle hoo. She clearly stated that the victim ran right!
Oh, it is simple. Yeah, I misheard her. No, we didn't.
I think not. Look at the floor plans. Oh, we were so right. We were so right, but we were so off. Come on, why couldn't we have shown a photo? Because I know they're gonna say, because I mean... All the things are way in the left, and that was just the way we were thinking, and then you're like, no, you can't use that, you should have been thinking about... Oh, that's so annoying!
And the victim here.
If the victim ran to the left, as you claim she did, she would have been running directly away from the door. Oh, that's so annoying! That's so annoying! She would have been running into a dead end, and that makes sense!
Tell her.
Don't you find that odd?
Oh wow, look at that face. Wow, that really looks like...
Why did you give me licorice instead of freaking chocolate? Okay, my mouth, I can't...
That's the expression you have in your face, Wright. Oh, you're ashamed now.
Very strange. I don't like... I think I like licorice because I'm perfect and I need to like everything.
I did see her to run to the left. I did.
What the hell? Phoenix, look at his face. I don't think he's lying about this one.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because... I mean, he will murder her after all, so for him, it was maybe, yeah, that was their left. Maybe he really did see the victim run left, of course, because I mean, he murdered her, so she ran to the left.
That makes sense, yes, that makes sense. So he did witness killing.
Wait a second,
oh my gosh, have you really, is this when you get it? Like, yeah, he did it?
Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor.
Miss May says right, and Mr. White says left.
Miss May, I think it's Maya. Can you explain this contradiction to the court?
Miss May is right. No, both are right, both are right.
Both witnesses are telling the truth, for once.
Why, YMCA? I don't know why I have that in my head.
I doubt it. Rather, that does not clear up the contradiction.
There's one scenario that would explain the conflicting accounts.
Are you saying to stand up, sing hallelujah?
Sorry, I guess I'm so happy.
What?
Obviously, the witness was not viewing crime from the hotel.
Order, order.
Mr. Wright, what do you mean?
Please put him in jail, I really want to. I really just want, you know, get, I don't want him to, you know, blackmail me anymore. Please be right about this, please put him in jail.
Yes, what do you mean? He was not hearing the cry from the hotel.
Jazz!
Bam, slam, slam, bam, 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 this bang.
If he was not in the hotel, what could he have been?
What do you think, you poo-poo?
In the law offices of Faye and Co., of course.
Yay, snap, 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 a doodle.
More specifically, he was standing here.
Show the court where Mr. White was standing.
Show the, okay, killer, killer. There we are. That, perfect.
There we go, perfect. Oh, snap.
Yeah, snap, snap, snap.
I'm sorry for snapping my fingers into the microphone. Look here. When the victim ran for the door, if he was watching from this point, to him it would appear that she ran to the left.
Everybody stand to the left, oh yeah. What, are you serious? Come on, alright, you got a lot of, you're getting a lot of money for saying this sort of thing, so okay, I understand.
Please, this is not time for jokes and L-tires.
That is why the color was standing. Why are you just slow? We told you that Mr. White is the murderer.
Okay, I'm sorry, you're not slow. Mr. White murdered Mia, so now you understand, okay? Okay, I'm sorry for calling you slow. I'm kinda slow too, sometimes I just don't get information that very quickly, so it's okay. Don't be sad, Mr. Edgeworth. Don't be sad. You're doing a great job, even though you're a crook.
Order. I will have order. Anyone disturbing the order of this courtroom will be held in contempt. Mr. Wright, what are you suggesting?
That he's the freaking murderer. Come on, hang. You're in the game, people.
Rapscallion.
I was sweating.
The postulations of the defense are a distortion of the truth, Your Honor.
What?
Indeed, they do seem a bit far-fetched.
Are you for serious?
Ho ho ho. Blackmail. Blackmail's powers activate.
You provide us with so much entertainment, Mr. Lawyer.
What now? He's laughing.
Of course he is, because he's a poo-poo.
The hilarity of the moment made me remember something. It appears I have been unclear, and for this, I apologize.
But weren't you perfect? You can't do... No, you're perfect. You can't do false. So, in your face, you're not perfect. How? I burn. Feel the burn. Mm. No one's perfect. Everyone's just awesome. But you're a poop because you killed Mia, so that you're not awesome. You're just a poop.
Mister, Your Honor. Might I be allowed to testify once more?
No. Just go to jail. We all know you did it.
Very well, let's hear your revised testimony.
Good luck, you can't fix a broken testimony, buddy. Except if you got blackmailers doing your blackmailing for you. Nah, you can't get away with that.
Not when Mrgreenhp and the beautiful, beautiful people, our friends, standing in your way, Red White. We're gonna put you in jail for what you did to our friend and for smacking us in the face.
Okay. She ran to the left. No, she ran to the right.
Miss Mary's testimony was correct, as was mine. Because I did kill her. When you assaulted the girl, she first ran to the left.
Oh, wow, really?
And then you hit her savagely, that is what I saw. And next, with the last of her strength, she ran to the right.
But the... No, she couldn't have done that. Because... The one-hit kill, you remember that? Or... If you're gonna take the fake later one, you know, the autopsy, the fake one that, Edgeworth put on the table. Like, maybe she was able to write something, like, with the last of her strength, but...
She couldn't possibly have run to write later.
You chased her, and delivered the final blow.
But, only once we struck. Come on, what? That's not gonna work. And don't show us sad pictures.
And that is what Miss May saw. You see, he hit her twice.
No, we didn't.
Don't you remember, Mr. Lawyer?
Snickers.
That does seem to me.
Really? You were here at the last trial. It's always the same judge. Come on. This does... Oh, it's so sad that you have to force yourself to say this, Minx, because you would never have said this, like, if you weren't, you know, being blackmailed by him. I just know it, Judge. I believe in you. Everyone believes in you. Come on. Come on now.
And Minx, will you be cross-examined with this testimony?
Do you even need to ask? You bet I will. I mean, yes. You poo.
Evil stare.
And she ran to the left. When you assaulted the girl, she first ran to the left. And then you hit her savagely, that's what I saw. Next, with the last of her strength, she ran to the right. Is that the one we should do? Chase her and deliver the final blow. That is what Miss May saw. You see, you hit her twice. This is what we can do. We can present the autopsy, right? No, not that one. I thought that was the autopsy. Oh, wait, there we go. Died from a blow by a blunt object. May have lived for a few minutes after being hit. But it says a blow, and that means one blow, right? So, let's go. Yeah, it seems like to be right.
Mr. White!
The victim died from a single blow.
Man, the licorice, not again!
What do you have to say to that?
Oh, I'm sorry, I just burped. I just put me in jail. Put the handcuffs on me. Just take me away.
Now's my chance to hit him where it counts.
Snap it.
Mr. White, wasn't it you who told this court you were...
Oh, yeah, Phoenix, you're saying right. You're saying right stuff. Yes, you said the Sphinx. I just said, oh, yeah. I said it maybe a couple of minutes ago. But still,
wasn't it you who told this court you were absolutely perfect?
Oh, snap.
I will refrain from using this phrase. No.
We are the champions, my friends.
I'm sorry. I'm just so freaking glad that line came out of his mouth. That sentence. Sublime.
Your Honor, if you could ask the witness for a new testimony, that would be a laughable at least.
The witness is honestly confused, Your Honor.
Wow.
Oh, come on, don't do that, don't do this, don't do this. Oh, that's so freaking frustrating. They're gonna lie, put up a lot, bunch of lies, and they're gonna be like, ah, oh, yeah, I was drunk or something. Mr. White's gonna say that. I don't know.
Unlike the rate cost of 10 minute break.
Yes, quite.
That's so freaking mean. The witness is confused because he's lying. My neck broke again.
I am perfectly request that there be no break, Your Honor.
Yay, we want justice. Oh yeah, I love you, the crowd. Don't let him get away. Oh yeah, Macarena. Oh yeah. Oh no. Do 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 do. Yeah, judge, get it in your face. I'm so happy. I'm so sorry. I'm enjoying this now. This is getting fun in your face, freaking boy. This is good. This is for hurting me in my face and also hurting me.
I miss Mia so much.
Okay.
If the witness would care to revise his testimony.
The crowd's on my side, I'm slipping out of this now. Why? Exactly. Everyone's on your side. We told you from the beginning, Phoenix, we love you.
Mr. White.
Oh.
Okay. Oh. Witness testimony to two accounts.
Well, see, I looked at the other window when I heard that thing fall.
What thing? Then? What thing? What thing fall? Mia's buddy?
Then, the next moment I saw Miss Mia run through left. Then, the killer, you, attacked her, but she dodged. And then, she turned and ran for the door.
What?
Then you did it. And then you did her in with a single blow. Flap!
Oh, you're sweating. Are you sweating?
Flap indeed. Seriously? Very well, you may begin the cross-examination if you need one.
Yes, we need it! Come on, you don't even need to ask us, Judge. Come on, man.
Mr. Your Honor.
Mr. Your Honor. My stomach, you see, it's hurting. I can't give you your original voice anymore. Nah, you gotta poop your pants right there. So, I'm sorry, I shouldn't say poop your pants. Even though he is probably gonna do that if he has a tummy ache.
Deal with it.
This is almost over, so you can go to the bathroom in jail. Well, first you gotta, you know, get the jail clothes, you know, prison clothes. And then you gotta take the bus to the jail. And then you gotta, you know, sign in and stuff, like sort of like a hotel. And then maybe you'll get to the bathroom. Nah, maybe then you need to, you know, say hello to all the other prisoners. But then after a while, maybe a couple of hours or so, you'll be able to go to the bathroom. So you're cool.
I need to wait hours.
Evil stare of winning. Well, and we're not evil, but, you know, it's worth evil.
Well, I see. I looked at the other window where I heard that thing fall.
What thing? What thing?
You heard that thing fall? What exactly was that thing?
Yeah, what was that thing?
Huh?
Oh, the glass lights then.
How the poop did you know that?
Right, the one that had fallen over at the scene.
How the poop did you hear that? Seriously, it was like building away. Doesn't sound he's trying to get out.
Yeah, very odd.
Yeah, that's odd. I press further. Mr. White?
Yes?
What?
You're saying you saw the glass light stand?
Yes!
Then change your testimony to reflect that!
Sorry.
Oh my god, you apologized! Oh, well, that's nice. I'm not gonna accept it because I still don't like you at all. I don't like your guts at all. But that kind of feels nice. He says he's sorry.
Let's see. I wonder if we have anything with glass shards. I don't know if we do when I think about it.
The witness would revise his testimony.
Can we look at court record now? Yeah, we can.
Oh, we do get some glass shards.
The broken remains of a glass light stand, broken beyond all recognition. But I don't think we can use that, really.
Oh, okay. Okay, of course. A light stand was lying on the floor when I looked.
How could you look at the floor? Should we present the glass shards on this, like present it, or should we just press here? Yeah, I think it would be better just to press.
The glass stand was lying on the floor. That's the first I've heard of this. Why didn't you tell us about the stand before?
What? Me?
You get a new voice all the time now. Well, I was instructed not to... Oh! One moment! Give me a minute to get my thoughts! I am so confused. Oh, yes, of course you are. Why it's falling apart.
Yeah, sure. Your Honor, please, I ask that you do not allow the witness to be badgered any further.
Mr. Wright, please refrain from badgering the witness.
Really? What? Yes, Your Honor? What? Why did you say yes? Edgeworth's
on the ropes. Very well. The witness may continue his account.
But then the next moment I saw Miss Mayor run to the left. But that's the glass shut, right? She turned around for the door, then you did her in with a single blow. Flap.
Phoenix is getting a lot less talkative. Again, a lot less talkative. He's probably afraid I'll catch him on something. But it won't be easy. I don't know.
I was lying for when I looked. But it sounds like it was not broken, so maybe we should try to present the glass shard. But maybe we should just present the floor plans. Because, you know, the window... Like, how could he have seen glass shards on the ground from that angle he was in? I don't... Maybe it's best to just present the glass shard, but I don't want to lose any... Like those marks of there. I don't want to lose them, my life or whatever that's supposed to be. But I'm gonna try this. I don't know. I'm so confused. I really just really want to get over this and get past this.
Mr. White. It was impossible for you to have seen that light stand.
What?
The stand was broke into pieces when it fell. Okay. Okay, so we should have presented this, and then maybe we'll get a chance we can present a photo. Maybe they will get all angry at us if we present a photo. I mean, the floor plans.
Ooh!
Just by seeing the broken pieces, you would have no idea it was a light stand.
Oh.
So tell me exactly when was it that you saw the stand?
You sneak.
Answer the question!
I bet she was gonna say,
objection!
Obvious. I saw the stand before it fell over.
Oh, you did?
So, you saw the stand before the victim was attacked then?
Correct. That would be no problemo, right?
No problemo?
Maybe, wait. When I think about it... No problemo. It is a problemo. Because the... I don't know. It's because how the stand was built, but I think we're gonna say big problemo. Please don't hurt me.
Okay, so that was... Okay, I just didn't understand the sentence. There's a big problemo here. Problem here.
What problem is this?
The photo.
Mr. White, let me make sure I have this straight. You saw the glass light stand through the window from the hotel. Before the incident occurred.
You sneaky snoop.
That is so, it's conclusive, definite, undeniable, unimpeachable.
Oh, really? You agree with us that that you're lying?
Yes, Gabe, like, yeah, I'm lying. It's because I totally saw the light that I couldn't be able to see.
No, it's impossible. You couldn't have seen the stand.
What? Why couldn't he? You have proof.
But come on, Judge, you have already seen all the proof.
We got it close.
Finally, we can use that picture of floor plans. Finally, we can use that.
I sure do, Your Honor. A person in the hotel could not have seen the stand before it fell over because...
Floor plans!
Take that! Snap a doodle!
Look at this! These are the floor plans to the scene of the murder, yes?
Yes, Judge.
Correct, Your Honor. Now look!
Oh my!
If you were to look through the window at the office, this is the area you would be able to see.
Here! Well, note that the stand is not within the visible area.
Maybe it was moved.
No, I didn't say that. You didn't hear that. Well, Mr. White, what do you have to say to that? Erasmus is satisfied.
Ridiculousity. Mr. White, if you were in the Gatewater Hotel as you claim, you could not have seen the stand before it fell over. In fact, you wouldn't have been able to see it after it fell either. There's no way you could have recognized the broken shards as a glass light stand.
And seriously, it was another building. How could you see anything? Seriously, that's just strange.
So when did you see the stand, Mr. White? Of course, at the manager's scene, probably. It must have been the moment that it fell. And the only place you could have seen that from is inside the Fatal Law offices. In other words, you had seen the crime when the murder took place.
Pikachu!
Just kidding. Not Pikachu. Pikachu is a Pokemon. This is real. No, this is... It's turn lap.
Mr. White?
Sorry, I gotta drink some water. My voice is getting all hurt for doing this voice. And then, this is just... What are we looking at? Are you having a seizure? Do you want us to get some help? Are you crying? I hope you're crying, because it would be horrible if you have a seizure, because I don't know how to help you, really, if you have a seizure on the computer screen. I don't know how to, stop a seizure on that the computer screen is having. I mean, a Nintendo screen is having.
Mr. White. You did it, didn't you? Mr. Your Honor. I, Miss Mia.
Looks like we're about to get a verdict.
Objection. Oh, come on.
That's fine, Mr. Phoenix Wright.
What? Eric, I forgot about Edgeworth.
Yeah, me too.
Mr. Wright. I think the time has come. Shouldn't you confess your crime now?
What? Edgeworth, what are you saying? Are you saying something that makes sense? No. This is not happening. Is this real life? I'm dreaming. I need to pinch myself.
No. This must be an all in act. This must be like tricking us to say something. I don't know. I'm so confused. I don't know. I don't know who I am right now. I don't even know who's Rasmus. I don't know.
Who's Edgeworth? I don't know.
Instead, you should confess your crime. Ergo. Confess that you placed the wiretap.
Oh. Okay. The wiretap. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Now, we're back into this game again.
Order. Mr. Edgeworth, we thought you were gonna say something good. Finally, something amazing for your little mouth, but you're just being Edgeworth. You trickery little trickster. Explain to the court what you mean by this.
Distinguished members of the court, Mr. White is slightly confused. Allow me to explain.
I really don't like the way this is headed. I don't like anything that Edgeworth is saying anyway.
As you know, Mr. White is the CEO of Blue Corp. He ordered his secretary, Ms. Abelman, to talk to the office of Ms. Faye.
What does that have to do with anything?
Your Honor, the question is, when was the White placed in the office by who?
No, you wouldn't.
Mr. White, in order to place the wiretap, you entered Ms. Faye's office. Am I correct?
I hate you, Edgeworth. I'm sorry, but yes, I hate you, Edgeworth. You're an awful person.
You're gonna help this person to get away. We're so close to putting this poo-poo in jail. How dare you?
Correct, you are most correct, Miles.
First name basis, really?
Give me a break.
Yeah, seriously, give us a break. I need to lie down. I'm so mad.
Yes, in order to place a wiretap, I breached the Fane Cole offices. That is when I saw the accursed light stand.
Now I'm confused. Please explain to the court what all this means, Mr. Edgeworth.
Yes, I don't wanna see your face anymore, Edgeworth. Can you just put on a mask? I'm so mad at you. I'm mad at your face.
Well, Your Honor. Haha, Rasmus says, man, this is awesome. Mr. Phoenix Wright has made his position quite clear. He has determined that Mr. Wright near the glass stand was enough for us. He has shown that there was only one time Mr. Wright or Ness have seen the stand, at the very moment of the murder. Thus, Mr. Wright would like you to believe that Mr. Wright was the murderer, as I see. However, it is a fact that Mr. Wright had been to the office well before the murder took place.
Really?
He went to place it on top. He could have seen the glass lie stand down. There you go, Mr. Phoenix Wright. There is really a part of baseless conjecture it is.
I'm so mad. Mr. Wright. You will testify to the court about this wiretap.
Bling, bling, bling. Yeah, yeah.
Leave it to me.
I feel faint. Me too! I don't wanna do this anymore.
It was the beginning of September.
It was September, on the 21st night of September. The week before the murder, I entered the fan collar offices.
And there's like, oh, of course, I danced to place the wiretap, oh, of course. That is when I saw this glass last, and oh, it oh, na 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 way.
I'm sorry, that's the only way I can get all happy again to make it all silly to sing a song about it. Yeah.
So, you are not that good at singing, Mr. White. You saw the stand before the Night of the Innocent, and this is how you were able to identify what had fallen over by the sound.
Stop. Bling, 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 bling.
Correct. That is right. I see. Very well, Mr. Wright. You may cross-examine.
Examine. God, what am I supposed to do now? Punch him? No, punch him. Good luck, Phoenix. Why do you look so mad at us? Evil ass of doom, you silly Billy.
Edgeworth, beep!
It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder. I had entered the fan car law offices. Of course, I danced to play the wiretap. I don't remember where I put the melody before. And that's when I saw this light stand.
Now nobody, yeah. Definitely hammer, dang it. There's nothing there for me to press him on, then and there. Oh, well, maybe it's right now that I can blow something out of him.
Wait, no. White was the one singing, not you, Phoenix. What are you doing?
I don't know.
Okay, I'm not gonna sing anymore.
It was the beginning of September, the week before the murder. I had entered the Fayon Cole offices. Of course, I done so to place the wiretap.
I gotta look at the receipt for a little. Gonna look at this before. Department store is with letters written in blood on the back. Can we check the other? No, can't. Digging dungeon tag to right. The murder scene check. Okay. Uh-oh. Oh, wait. We have some. This is not something new. Be back, everybody. Be back. This is something new.
Uh-oh. Don't tell me I ran out of ammo.
Oh, gosh. Don't look at that smug face. Don't look at it, everybody. Don't look. It's gonna. I read and you just close your eyes and you don't have to see that smug face.
Tsk, tsk. I'm afraid that's as far as it comes, Brian. The time has come for you to admit your defeat.
Keep your eyes closed. He's still talking.
You fought honorably.
Yeah, but you didn't, so. Oh, he's bowsing. No, he's not. Don't listen. Okay, now you can listen, because now he stopped talking. You can open your eyes now.
No more. I can't take this anymore. Mr. Wright, are you giving up?
No.
Yeah. No, what are you doing, Phoenix? No, don't give up. Don't give up on life.
Phoenix? Who's talking? Phoenix, over here. Where?
I know that voice.
What? Mia! Oh, Mia, yes! Oh my god, what are you doing? Aren't you dead?
God, this is amazing! Never give up, Phoenix! Oh my god, Mia, I love you! Oh my gosh!
Oh my god.
gosh. And this is not good for me because of my bladder. Oh my gosh, I gotta go to the bathroom like last time. Oh my jeez. Mia.
Oh my god, Mia.
What, were you faint? Did we faint? Did we just faint?
Don't tell us we did. Where? Where am I?
In heaven. Just kidding. The waiting lobby. What happened?
I know. Oh, right. I lost the trial. I was hallucinating.
Oh, we were losing. Oh, no, we're not! Oh, yeah, Mia. Oh, yeah, Mia, you awake. Oh, yeah, Mia, you alive. Oh, maybe she's not. Maybe it's just... Okay. Yeah, Maya is a spirit. No, no, no. I'm not gonna go through that. Mia's alive. Mia survived. I told you, Mia was just sleeping. And I didn't read what it said. I just... Gah. Hey, Phoenix. Da-da-da. Gak? That's no way to greet an old friend. Oh, I'm sorry. You're gonna get your normal voice. Phoenix, I want you to look at me. Whoa! That's... You changed your clothes really quickly. You're Maya? Didn't you know the Fae women have strong physic powers? But Maya... So that she was not at that level yet. When you accepted your defeat in court, it appears that there was enough of a shock to awaken Maya's true powers. Oh, really? Oh,
but I want you to be awake. I'm not sleeping anymore. I wanted you to still be around. I'm so happy. Why did you say that? Why can't you just be alive? I'm disappointed.
So, Maya channeling you, Mia? That's right, I'm Maya. But I'm also Mia. Now I want you to listen to me, Phoenix.
I want you to be alive. Oh, Maya never gave up. You can't eat her. That's why I came here to tell you.
But, we don't have much time, Phoenix. Now listen. You are already won.
Yes, I have.
Wait, you have that receipt. Yes, I knew there was something about the receipt. You have the receipt in the court record, right?
Oh yeah, the one you wrote my on.
Phoenix, White wrote that, not me. Oh, I knew it! We knew it all along, didn't we? Didn't we, my friends? We did.
So what do I do with it?
Look at the front end of the receipt. I wanted to do this for so freaking long! Thank you, Mia. This is why I love you. This is why you're one of my favorite characters. And this sucks that you were put off so quickly.
It's a regular receipt. Looks like it's from a famous department store.
$1,000. Wow, big spender. Hey, big spender. Item, last license. Oh my gosh, I was so right. I couldn't become a lawyer.
Data perk is September the 4th.
Yeah, Mia. Seriously, Mia had to appear because Phoenix couldn't look at the freaking front of the freaking receipt.
You're even given the nickname Detective by all the people we encountered. And you didn't even look at the front of the receipt that everyone was shouting at the screen. Mia, I love you. Why did you leave? That's right, Phoenix. I bought that stand the day before I was killed.
What?
Now, what did Mr. White say in his testimony? A week before that.
It was the beginning of the September, the week before the murder.
He said he saw the stand the week before the murder. There you go.
I think the court is about to reconvene?
Go do it, Phoenix. You know you're innocent. Now you just have to prove it.
Mia, love, you don't leave.
Right.
Receipt updated in the court record.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
September 9, 1:16 p.m. District Court, courtroom number 1.
Oh no.
The court will now reconvene for the trial of Mr. Phoenix Wright. Is the defendant rather, or are you alright, Mr. Wright?
I can't give you your voice anymore because I have my sour throat. Yes, sorry, Your Honor. Why are you saying sorry? I'm fine now.
Then, let's start where we left off.
Smoke base. Your Honor. There's nothing to get back to. The cross-examination of Mr. White's finished. All that is required is for you to pass your judgment on the defendant, Phoenix Wright.
snap, Your Honor. Please give me one more chance.
Bitter chance on mine, bitter chance on me. Okay, I'm gonna quit the scene because that's gonna make my throat even more sour.
I'm sore. Not sour, what the heck am I saying? I promise you, this is the last time I'll ask you.
Because we're right now. Because Mia is freaking the best.
But as Mr. Edgeworth has noted, trial is more or less finished.
Well, you're all right, because this is finished, because you can't come back from what we're gonna give you.
Mr. Edgeworth, do you have an opinion on this matter?
Let's give Mr. Phoenix Wright this last chance.
Oh, you're gonna regret saying that, Edgeworthy Poo.
Very well. You may begin your cross-examination.
Evil Aster of Happiness. It was the beginning of September, and the 25th night of September. You're gonna regret this. Okay, wait, should we say the week before the murder? Or should we put this on the lamp thing? I think we should present it here. Snap. Sorry for snapping in your microphone again. Look closely at this. See the word Maya written in blood. Boha! You're
grasping.
I think not. Look at the other side of the receipt, my fellows. The other side? Really? No one thought of this except Mia? And, well, us. Your Honor, would you tell the court what is written on the other side of the receipt? Oh, wow. This is so satisfying. Thank you, Mia. I love you. I love you.
Well, a glass light stand and the date of purchase. Why? That's the day before the murder.
Oh, my gosh. Is this happiness?
Oh, you see, Mr. White, when you allegedly entered the Fay and Cole offices at the beginning of September, I'm not even mad that I couldn't pronounce that allegedly blah word. Because I'm so happy right now. Snap, my neck hurt. I don't even care because I'm happy. The stand could not have been there. Are you crying with your face? Oh, yay! Oh my god!
You're going to jail.
Well, Mr. White, you're not right.
Can't get out of this one, can you?
No, it's impossible.
Uh-oh, he's losing it.
Okay, Phoenix, you run outside the door. You're just gonna run, pick up Maya with you, and, well, there's no one else in the courtroom that cares, because Mia's inside of Maya's body, so we're gonna bring all the important people, because I don't know if Maya's gonna, you know, I know if they're paying attention. Okay, yeah, they're totally paying attention. They're the only people paying attention in this thing. So Maya and Mia grabs you, and you just run out there, so, you know, so Wyatt doesn't go all Gaston on you. So you gotta run. Okay, you're still standing, I guess. Okay, because you're a badass. Okay, we go on then.
Well, Your Honor, I understand there must be quite a bit of pressure on you. But I think you'll agree you can't judge me guilty under these circumstances.
Oh, yeah!
Very well.
Oh! Are you saying to stand up, sing hallelujah?
Hallelujah!
Then that is all for the trial of...
No! Stop! I was so happy. I was so happy. That's Edgeworth. Edgeworth. It's a douche doo 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 boo 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 head.
No, it's a bad thing to play.
Eh? What? No way he can worm his way out of this one. Of course he can. It's Edgeworth. Oh wait, I forgot. It's Edgeworth. It's Edgeworth. Edgeworth. He's a little poo 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 head. It's Edgeworth. Edgeworth. He's a poo poo head that likes to bow.
This is an event of logic due to the defense claims. However, there is no concrete proof that Phoenix Wright is innocent.
What?
Ergo, I would like to request one more day before Phoenix Wright is kind of free.
What?
I need time to make one more
One more inquiry into this matter.
Another inquiry.
This isn't going to be another one of those updated autopsy reports. This guy just makes up evidence as he pleases. This is bad.
Of course we can object.
Mr. White's guilt is obvious.
There's no need to prolong the trial any further.
Well, Mr. Edgeworth.
Parents. Parents, I know. If anyone's going to call Mr. White to trial, it would mean the prosecution. Any data send when your claims have any basis in actual evidence.
No. I see. Objection.
What? Are you kidding me? No! There's no telling what will happen if I can't end this now! Edward is sure to come up with or just make up something. And Optimian showed up to help me and after all. Oh, I'm your bling bling!
Mr. Your Honor, may I go home?
No! What the poop? Why?
Of course. Thank you for your...
Summon!
The witness will stay.
Mia!
Mia?
Phoenix, I'm here to save your ass again, because I'm awesome. Read this note out loud.
Mia? What's this?
Oh yes. Mia, I love you. Memory received from Mia. Oh my gosh, I love you so freaking much.
Your Honor, if I may. You're quite persistent today, Miss Wright.
Well, you wanna put me for the murder of my best bud? What the poop do you think? So mad, you judge. Murder, you don't even got puppy eyes like Grossberg. You bet I am, my life is riding on this one, and Mia's honor. I have something I would like to read to the court. So mad.
If this is not it, I'm gonna... The memo Mia had given me was a list of names. Many of them sounded strangely familiar. People in finance, famous celebrities. That's when it happened.
Stop! This is halt! Please stop! Make him stop! How did you get that list?
What list? Mr. White. Admit your guilt right here, right now. Or else this list will be released to press.
Ooh, we got blackmail on White now. You stand up quickly.
I confess. I did it. I hit her. I hit Miss Mia with the finger.
Case closed, Your Honor.
Oh! Boom! Oh my god! Mia, you freaking...
I love you. I love you so freaking much. There's no one I love more than you, Mia.
You're a freaking beast!
Well, I see no reason to continue this trial, Mr. Wright.
Yes, Your Honor. You have done it again. That was quite a spirited defense. Oh, because we had a spirit along with us.
Yes, Your Honor. I guess you could say that. If only you knew how spirited the spirit and it was.
Well, this court finds the defense. Rather, the defendant, Mr. Phoenix Wright.
Not guilty! Confetti, yes, put it all over my body! We did it!
That is all. The court is adjourned.
Mia, I love you. I love you so much. All the people in the world named Mia are the freaking best. I only knew awesome Mia people, and I... Well, all of you watching are freaking awesome, but... Bleh. Mia, oh wow, Mia. Oh, Mia Faye, why did you die? September 9th. 2:24 p.m. District Court Defendant Lobby Number 1.
Mia, don't leave.
Well, I never thought I'd be saying this again, but congratulations. You're lucky I was born a fae.
Yeah, we were seriously lucky, thank you.
I'm lucky I had both you and Mia on my side. I'm glad you made it. Thank you, Phoenix. You risked a lot to help me, and Mia. I won't forget it as long as I live.
Oh, that means you're alive. I was right from the beginning.
As long as you live.
My time is running out.
No.
Huh?
No. Maya's powers are not weak. They're freaking strong because they are no.
Maya's power is still weak. I can't stay here that long.
What? No. There's still so much to say. Yeah.
Don't worry.
I'm sure we'll meet again. Oh, okay. Well, then it's feel better. Now I feel better. I feel better now.
Me, I love you. Don't leave.
Okay, well, we're gonna see each other soon, so I'm just gonna have patience, even though I don't have... I'm not that great with patience, but...
Oh, I love you.
Sheaf! Hehe. I'm not the sheaf anymore. Phoenix, can you come to the office tonight? Say 9.
The office?
I see you later. Sheaf! Mia! No, you're not supposed to say sheaf anymore. Mia just told you that. September 9, 9:02 p.m. Finco offices.
Wait, are you late?
Being here, it's hard not to think about that night. You came!
Mia?
I was kind of worried you might not.
Huh? Of course I came.
Well then. I'm pretty hungry. How about a burger? Oh, it's Maya!
Mia?
No, it's Maya.
Bwahahaha! You should see your face! Mia?
It's Maya! What are you talking about? It's me, Maya!
Maya? Of course it's Maya. What do you think?
What, did I look like my sister? If it makes you happy, of course.
You look like you were her.
I might be able to use that. Oh, Phoenix, go to the store and buy me lunch, would you?
Maya, why are you here?
Because of this! See, Mia wrote me a letter. To care Phoenix for me.
Oh, Mia! You gave us Maya's... Maya's gonna look over us, protect us! Oh, Mia!
To care of... Huh? She means the office. This office, but... But we love... But Maya, you should protect us because... Why not? Why not?
Someone has to help with a new Wright and Cole office.
My god, we got our own law offices?
And who better but me, Maya Faye, reporting for duty. Yay, salute you.
Wait, no. On a second thought, let's make this casual.
Joe, Nick, Maya, hey, ready to get down to business. You're down to business.
You don't mind me calling you Nick, do you? Who's Nick? Seriously, who the heck is Nick? Phoenix? Is that like a nickname from Phoenix? Maybe. It's a great name. Mia said that that's what your friend Larry calls you.
Mia, remember that Larry's name was Larry, not Harry. Oh, Mia.
Nick?
You know what this means.
We're partners.
Partners in crime.
Wait, no, not crime.
Partners in justice.
Oh my god, finally.
You know, when I think about it, it is Mia's fault I'm here now.
What?
But if it wasn't for her, I'd probably be in jail. Yeah. Ryan and Cole Law Offices. It's got a good ring to it.
Yeah, it does. Oh my god. Oh my god, my friends. We're lawyers for realsies.
Yeah.
Thanks, Maya. Thanks, Mia.
Oh, Mia. I love you so much. Oh, Mia. No. You're so... Oh, you're the freaking best.
I don't like White. Why did he murder you? You're such a nice and awesome, lovely person. Good luck, Phoenix.
Oh, no.
I'll always...
They say this in movies when it's sad. No.
I'll always be here watching.
Oh, Mia, no. I'm so grateful that I have you watching over us.
Right, okay, Nick, let's do this.
Huh? Do what? Oh gosh, this is gonna be your name. This is gonna... No, name. This is gonna be your accent. This suits you with the words you're using.
Burgers, dummy. Burgers. There's a great burger joint just down the street. Come on, time's wasting.
Yeah, this is your accent now. Oh, okay, wait up.
D.N. This... Oh, yes. Oh, finally. A brand new episode has been added. Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Samurai? Tell me about Samurai. Ooh.
Oh, wow. We don't need to be reminded anymore of that Mia, our best buddy, died. Oh, this is so... Oh my gosh, I'm so happy. Wow. But I'm so happy that we don't need to be reminded of Mia's death, because that really, really made me sad. Because I really liked her from the start. She was just... All the awesome things she said, she was always on point. She really felt like a person that you can meet in real life, because Phoenix and Maya, they felt like, or all the other characters, they doesn't feel like real people, but Mia really connected with me. I really felt like she was a real person.
and maybe also that I know someone with her name, so maybe I connected with that even more, and that made me really, really sad when she died. I don't know. There's a lot of reasons. I just really like the character, and then they just put her off, and we had to save her, and save her reputation, to save her honor, to and not put her little sister in jail, and not to put her apprentice or her... one of her co-workers to be put in jail for a murder. I can't even speak anymore. I'm just so satisfied. It feels like I have had this huge meal, and you know that feel that you feel after you had a huge meal and it was delicious? That's kind of how I feel right now. Wow. Well, thank you so much for watching this, and also thank you for commenting and liking, and wherever you are, whether it's day or night, I hope you are having a great time. Thank you for joining in on the battle against Red White. Finally, that poo-poo is in jail. This feels amazing. Ooh, wow, this is amazing. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye!
Oh, no.
Come here. I'm gonna trick you. Come here. Go. Yeah! Tell me about yourself.